Howdy folks, welcome back to the channel. Once again, we are talking about the 40th anniversary of Alien, 1979's Alien. I feel like the majority of this channel, since its birth, has been about the 40th anniversary of Alien. In almost every single one of my videos, I seem to somehow mention it, whether it's the figures, or the short films, or the re-release of Alien in theaters, I'm always talking about it. And yes, I came prepared once again with the chestburster shirt. So in case you don't know, NECA is not done with the 40th anniversary, apparently. We did get the ultimate Big Chaff Alien. Technically, it's not released yet, but some people do have it. And we already received the quarter scale Big Chaff as well. And I honestly thought that was going to be it. I mean, around Christmas time, they did hint at a quarter scale 79 Ripley and an ultimate style of 79's Ripley. And that was all fine and well. I thought, okay, so they're just throwing a little bit more at us. I get it. But then, apparently, we're not just getting Ripley. We're not just getting Parker and Brett, who were also teased last year. We're getting three waves of 40th anniversary figures. That is a hell of a lot more than I expected. Randy, the head of the company on Twitter, said that he's been planning this for a while, and this 40th anniversary line is the reason he's not going through with a lot of other Alien Predator stuff this year, because it wouldn't fit with the theme. So this year is gonna be interesting with all this 40th stuff. And I've been paying attention to NECA's social media pretty closely over the last couple of weeks, simply because we're not just getting three waves at Target. We're getting three waves at three different retail locations, which we'll get into later. But before that, before we dig in, let's just take a look at some general tweets that Randy made recently. So a guy on Twitter went out and asked who else will be in Wave 1, and my phone went off, sorry. So NECA responded, shown last week in the pictures shown here, we're getting Dallas in the prototype suit version of the Big Chap, and we're also getting that Ultimate Ripley that I mentioned. So yeah, last week or whenever, you know, I'm filming this on February 5th, so it's already been a while, NECA did reveal that, look, here's the entire first wave, with some pretty catchy boxing, if I do say so myself. I really like the retro design they went with, kind of like the quarter scale Big Chap. So we're getting a re-release of the spacesuit version of Dallas. I can't really see any changes between this one and the previous one from years ago. I bet you the paint is a little bit different, that the sculpting or the mold is just a bit more spot on. But for the most part, we're getting a re-release with new packaging. The same goes for the prototype Big Chap. We got a prototype in the past. This one is pretty much exactly the same. But again, I bet you the paint is going to be better. Now, the big one, of course, was Ripley. And it looks pretty gosh darn cool. They're doing that new facial recognition software or something. And essentially, it's an Ultimate 79 Ripley. Obviously, the facial likeness is much better because of that programming. Still not 100% spot on, but pretty gosh darn good. And we're getting loads of new accessories, at least compared to the previous Ripley. I mean, yeah, we're getting the flamethrower like usual, and we're getting a carry case for Jonesy, and of course Jonesy herself. So if you wanted to recreate the scene from the end of the film, the 79 film, there you go. And I'm trying to look for differences in the outfit compared to the original. I don't have them next to each other, honestly, but it looks like it's pretty much the same. I think the shoes are a little bit different. I can almost confirm that. Unfortunately, the hands are still the same. I wasn't a big fan of the joints on the hands of the original Ripley. They couldn't really move too well. The swivel joint was just not good, or whatever kind of joint they used. Looks like they're using the same one, but I could be wrong. But obviously the biggest change is the head, right? Again, that new software they're using, definitely more on point than the last one, but still a little bit off. But I can tell you that. It's a lot better than the first one. So definitely looking forward to a new Ripley. Long overdue. You know, the original figures, they came and they went. So for people who missed the originals, there you go. So you're getting Ripley, a new Dallas, and a re-release of Dallas and a re-release of the prototype suit of the alien, which, again, looks really, really cool. So there you go. That is Wave 1 of the 40th Anniversary Collection. Essentially, big re-releases, right? Once again, long overdue. So I'm happy they're doing this. I really am, and hopefully that'll inspire them to re-release other figures. But we will see. And one thing about the Ripley that I did miss is you're getting the big, chunky motion tracker, which we haven't gotten that before. So that is really, really cool. Anywho, let's move on to Wave 2. And returning to that same tweet, they said Wave 2 is Brett, which we knew about, is Parker, which we also knew about, and dot, dot, dot. Okay, what does that mean, NECA? I mean, we know we're getting some new characters, but who is the third one going to be in Wave 3? Let's go to another tweet where they kind of tease us a little bit more on some of those figure firsts. This one in particular. The Twitter user Hive Builder went out and put a picture of Parker, Brett, and Dallas saying, "I hope you hashtag make it hurt and leave us all utterly stunned." NECA replied, "Maybe I can breed it on Holm." Ian Holm? AKA Ash? Are we finally getting Ash from the original Alien as part of Wave 2? Is this a reality? Obviously, Ian Holm, he did pass away some time ago, so it makes me wonder how they would get his license. Probably family, whoever owns it now, or, you know, whatever. I don't know the legalities behind it, but obviously we're getting an Ash. So I hope this isn't just a tease and that we're actually getting this for real, because that would be amazing. Ash is definitely a highly requested figure from NECA's Alien line. So same thing with Kane, which I do hope is coming. We did get Kane technically, but we didn't get his likeness. Can we please get his likeness? NECA's been trying, we know that, but try hard or damn it. So yeah, there you go. Wave 1 and Wave 2. Wave 2 is still incomplete. We don't know. Hopefully it's Ash. We'll see. What about Wave 3? What is going to be in that? Are we going to get new figures and not just re-releases? And when are we going to see Wave 3 announced? Turning to this tweet from NECA, "We will show you all three waves at Toy Fair in 3 weeks. Now, Toy Fair is February 22nd to the 25th. Once again, I'm filming this on the 5th of February, so we got some time. And they continued on saying 9 figures in total, okay, and a few figure firsts. So there you go. What is Wave 3 going to be? Okay, so Wave 2 is going to probably be Brett. It's going to be, well, not probably, we're going to get Brett, we're going to get Parker, and most likely Ash. What about Wave 3? What are we going to be getting? So Kane is kind of foreseeable. I really do hope that we can get a Kane. It's possible that we're going to be getting a regular suited Lambert, a regular suited Dallas. Okay, I mean, we definitely need those. That could be cool. One thing that crossed my mind, and something that I can definitely see happening, because they did it with Aliens, is a Ridley Scott figure. They did it with James Cameron, right? They did the James Cameron Marine figure. Why wouldn't they do it with Ridley Scott? I mean, if he would give them his likeness, yeah. Now, honestly, I hope that's not the case. I hope we get characters from the film, but we will have to wait and see. So, February 22nd. Is Toy Fair 2020, when we're going to see all three waves in total. To sum them up, Wave 1 is Ultimate Ripley, re-release of Xeno, the prototype Xeno, and Dallas. Wave 2, Brett, Parker, most likely Ash. Wave 3, to be announced, but few figure first. So I am hoping that we are going to get not a Ridley Scott, but a flippin' Kane. Please give us a Kane with his likeness. We need his likeness. The one you did was pretty cool with the face hugger and stuff, but we need to see his face, okay? Unless, if you really can't get it, you'll probably give us like a half-naked Kane on a table with the face hugger still attached to him. And honestly, I would take that over no Kane period. So we will have to wait and see with that one. So how are you going to get a hold of these figures? Not all of them are going to be available at Target or online, okay? In this tweet, NECA said Wave 1 is going to be Target, okay? Wave 2 is going to be Specialty, which is kind of vague. Wave 3 to be announced. The above applies to the U.S. only, available worldwide non-exclusively. Okay. To be announced. One thing that kind of crossed my mind, I guess it can kind of work with Specialty, is GameStop. Are we going to be getting GameStop exclusive figures? They did it with Pennywise, and they did it with the Ninja Turtles, though that, I guess that was for different reasons since they absolutely couldn't put it at Target. The movie Turtles, the 90s ones, not the two packs and stuff. So I really don't know what's going to be happening. If it's GameStop, I guess it shouldn't be too bad. I will pre-order online if it's GameStop, because my GameStops suck. there's like nothing there ever. And I think honestly they're going to be shutting down our locations near us pretty soon. So, to be announced. I don't know if it'll be announced at Toy Fair, maybe later down the year, down the road. We will see. If I'm not thinking of something, that's why y'all are out there. Comment down below. What do you think is going to be for Wave 3? Again, something's telling me it's going to be GameStop. It's just the most realistic. But still, people have been freaking out on the social medias a lot, particularly on Twitter, attacking Mr. Randy and Mr. NECA. So NECA went out to say that, look, the line assortments have been carefully curated and planned per retailer and channel distribution. You'll be able to get whatever you need in the Alien 40th Anniversary Collection. No need to grab the torches and pitchforks. Then they went out to say, look, the sky isn't falling. How about we agree to panic and complain once there's something to actually panic and complain about? I agree with them. It's not going to be the end of the world. It's not going to be another Turtles situation. The Turtles were a really unique thing that happened, something we haven't gotten before. And I'd say the Turtle community is much smaller than the Alien Predator community, so those figures were really sought after by cult followers, right? At least from my perception. They were just like a once-in-a-lifetime type of thing, even though they went out to just keep re-releasing them. But you all remember the GameStop panic with those, right? And the whole exclusive thing to Comic-Con. So I wouldn't worry about it. If you don't get it the first time, they're going to be re-releasing it, I am sure. Again, like what they did with the Turtles. I'm sure it'll be just fine. Alrighty, folks. I think that pretty much covers the 40th Anniversary Collection. Again, I'm really, really happy with this. Wave 1, we're getting a long-awaited re-release of the Ripley, only with a new head sculpt and new accessories and a few changes to the mold. We're obviously getting another Dallas, which is awesome, and the prototype suit of the Big Chap, all in awesome packaging. And yes, I'm just so glad we're getting that little motion tracker thing that Ripley holds. That was such a cool thing in the movie. It's just this giant box that she had to carry around. It must have been god-awful for Sigourney Weaver just carrying this giant metal thing around with a goddamn cat in an even bigger crate, which we are also getting. And Wave 2, of course, Brett, which looks awesome, as you can see. I mean, check that out. We definitely need a Brett. And of course, Parker, who was also shown off recently. And I pray that we get Ash. Please give us Ash. If they do give us Ash, I guess I didn't really consider that we might get a battle-damaged version of him, which, you know, with the head flying off and everything. So that's what they might mean by figure first. So what are your thoughts about all this stuff? I know this is kind of relatively old news. I do apologize. Of course, we're in catch-up season. As usual, we're going to be like that for the next couple of videos. So comment down below. What are your thoughts? What are you looking forward to at Toy Fair? It doesn't even have to be Alien Predator related, because NECA's not just Alien Predator. There are a hell of a lot of other stuff. So whatever is on your mind, put the comments down below, and I do reply to absolutely everybody. It might take me a little bit of time, but I will get to you guys. Also, comment down below if you picked up the quarter scale Big Chap, the 40th anniversary version, and if you already got your hands on that Ultimate Big Chap as well. I haven't yet, hasn't been released for me, but again, I have seen people with the figure already. So if you're one of those folks, let me know how it is. I mean, it's pretty much just a repaint, some new accessories, but I still want to know what's up. Of course, go check out Trophy Room, a Facebook group created by myself for Alien Predators like yourself and like myself. Feel free to post anything Alien Predator related, whether it's the figures, the collectibles, the comics, the lore, the movies, whatever it may be. The only rule is don't be a dick. And as always, people, have a good morning, evening, midday, whatever, and take care. Ha 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 ha